Hello everyone and welcome to We Meet at Digital Days. My name is Marie-Therese Kohl and I will moderate this presentation. We are very pleased that you took the time to participate in our virtual conference. The topic of this presentation is high current, high voltage PDUs and EMC filters for vehicles. Our speaker is Ludovic Frilla. He will hold the presentation and will answer your questions. But before we start, I would like to point out one thing. You will be muted during the presentation. This means that you cannot ask questions via microphone during the presentation. Nevertheless, you have the opportunity to ask questions during the presentation at any time via the chat function. You will find the chat function in the control panel. This presentation will be about 30 minutes long. The chat questions will be answered in a Q&A session following the webinar. There are 5 to 10 minutes in addition scheduled for this. If we are unable to answer all your questions within this time, we will answer them via email afterwards. If you still have any other questions left, just mail us at exhibition@we-online.com. We will try to answer all questions promptly. At the end of the webinar, you will be asked to participate in a feedback survey. We would be pleased if you take the time to fill out the survey and help us to improve the event. You will also receive the link to the presentation in the next few days, and the recording will be available at our website shortly. But now I will hand over to our speaker, Ludovic, and I wish you an exciting presentation.
Good morning. Hello, everybody, and a warm welcome to today's webinar on the topic high current, high voltage, power distribution unit and EMC filters for vehicles. I'm Ludovic Frelin, and I'm product manager for e-mobility solutions by Wirth Electronic ICS. Wirth Electronic ICS is one of the three business units of the Wirth Electronic Group. Our product range includes intelligent solutions for power management with central electrical units, power boxes with our Redline platform, some controllers, some components, some HMI, and then some HV solutions, especially for power distribution units. Coming to the topic of the day, high current, high voltage, PDU and EMC filter. We will first start with PDU description and how it's connected in electric vehicle architecture. Then we will speak about PCB and press fit technology and which advantages it brings on PDU. I will show some examples of component integration on printed circuit board. We'll then have a look on PDU application and also a few examples of filter box. First of all, we have to define exactly what power distribution unit actually means. The goal or function of power distribution unit in an electrical vehicle is to interconnect and safely distribute the energy within the vehicle by switching the loads when needed. The second function is to protect the vehicle's electrical system, especially for the traction chain, and provide measurements to the vehicle controllers. The third important function is to allow safe and easy access to perform maintenance work. Let's speak about common battery electrical vehicle architecture. A power distribution unit is the central component that will connect, switch, and protect the different components of the powertrain of an electric vehicle. Typically, the electrical power is coming from the grid and stored in onboard battery through onboard charger or direct DC charging. This is the charging phase. The battery will then deliver some current to different components or loads like the electric motor, DC-DC converter, or some auxiliaries, for example, AC system, pumps, heater, and blower during the drive phase. In both cases, the PDU is the component that will allow to connect the different components together. If we focus on the vehicle topology, on a passenger car, the battery pack is located on the floor. The electrical traction motor is located at the front axle, the onboard charger near the AC plug, and the auxiliaries and DC-DC converter could be at the front or at the back of the vehicle. There is, in this case, only one power distribution unit, which distributes the electrical power to the different aggregates within the vehicle. That connection thematic that we just discussed is pretty easy to visualize on a simple vehicle, but it gets definitively more complex as soon as you start working on non-standard size vehicles like transportation, heavy duty or construction vehicles. Let's take an electrical city bus, for example. There are usually two battery packs located in that vehicle, for example, one at the back and another one on the roof. Then the electric motors are located on the axles, the thermal system on the roof, etc. You can imagine that in this case, connecting all these aggregates together with only one PDU is not the most efficient way to do it. That's why different smaller PDU are created to connect the components locally or per function. The power and also the voltage level used for such vehicles are also different than the ones we are using for passenger cars. In the case of an electric truck, the battery pack is located at the chassis near the trailer. Then motors are on the axle and the auxiliaries could be at the top or at the front of the vehicle. There are also some loads that can be present on the trailer. The PDU is generally located on the chassis. For such applications, the power is one of the key factors. It's logical if you think about the usage time of such vehicle within the day. If we take now the example of an electrical excavator, the battery pack is located on the tourelle, the different loads also. The PDU is located near these components. Here, the compactness is one of the key factors due to the size of the vehicle, but the battery capacity is also a challenge, especially due to difficulty to get grid access for charging the vehicles where they are used. Okay. Now we have spoken about the definition of power distribution unit and see that depending on the vehicle, there are many different architectures. Let's talk about pressfit. We are using solid pressfit, which means that solid pin with square shape is inserted into the metal hole of the PCB. This allows an important contact surface between the conductor and the PCB. Usually, 3 degrees of contact on the sides of the pin are enough to achieve similar cross-section to the pin. In reality, the contact surface is even bigger than 3 degrees. We can compare now this technology to the soldering technology, which is the most common used to connect electrically components on a PCB. In soldering technology, there are two different interfaces. The first is the interface between the pin and the solder material. The second is between the solder material and the PCB metal hole. In fact, these interfaces can be impacted by pollution or oxidation, but also some process problems can drastically affect the quality of the connection. The tin alloy used in soldering material is also a poor conductor. For solid pressfit technology, this is not the case. In fact, there is a direct contact between the pin and the metal hole. This creates a gas-tight connection without oxidation issues. The result of this is a lower contact resistance for the connection. If you focus now on the cross section, usually solder pins are thin in order to avoid thermal inertia in the soldering process. Limits are quickly achieved in terms of cross section, PCB thickness, copper layer thickness, number of layers, etc. This is not the case in pressfit. As the components are inserted in force, it's possible to use bigger conductors cross-section, thicker PCB, thicker copper layers, higher number of layers, but also more conductor pins on one component. You can see this on the picture below. The result is that press-fit contact can handle really high current in a PCB. This technology brings us a lot of advantage to design a product. In fact, an equipment of both sides of the board is possible. The first advantage is, of course, the compactness. The user interface are also optimized and easy to access. We can also place components in optimal position to achieve system constraints. We have also the possibility to create specific power elements that will simplify a lot the connection and get an adapted product. We have also the possibility to connect big cables or big components like fuses, contactors. We can also press fit locally some bus bar in order to reinforce the current carrying capacity. So in conclusion, this technology is most notably suitable for high current application and for the use under harsh environmental conditions. This is possible due to the excellent electrical characteristics, but also due to the excellent mechanical properties. It makes this a good choice to connect on a PCB the HV components of a PDU. Now let's focus on some components integration. As explained, we can design specific press-fit power elements to integrate components on a PCB. The first classical power element is the power one. This is mainly used to connect bus bar or cable lug on a PCB. In the picture below, you can see an example of a power one bush, which connects a bus bar with a washer and a screw. But we have also some power one male contact that will use washer and nuts to make the fixation. Here, a second type of power elements. This is the power two. This connection is realized with two parts located on both sides of the board. This is generally used to connect bigger components that must be screwed on the board. In this case, the compression is only between metal. It means that the PCB material is not included in the compression chain. You can see on this picture an example of an IGBT connection. So coming to integration of typical components present in PDU, we decided to work with design blocks. It means we have created different components that allow integration of different catalog parts. By reusing these design blocks, that allow us to create many custom specific designs that can fit to the system. You can see here some examples for contactors integration. For the contactor on the left side, you can see in green the power element that permit to screw and connect the power contacts to the PCB. You can also notice that small pins are also connected in the PCB without soldering to connect the coil and feedback signals. For this contactor, small power elements allow the connection with nuts and screw. The two power contacts are on the left side and the two coil signals on the right side. These first two contactors are directly connected to the PCB without any cable. The third contactor here has different design. It's placed horizontally and screwed to the PCB only for fixation. The electrical connection is realized with two right-angle power elements. The coil signals connection in this case is realized with a cable and a connector on the PCB. Fuse integration. This big fuse, typically 400 ampere, can be mounted to the PCB with two big power elements in green. This is similar to a bus bar mounting. The power element is quite massive in order to support the fuse and have a high number of press fit pins to carry the current to the PCB. The fuse can be easily dismounted from the top and changed. The second example of fuse is for smaller current, typically up to 30 ampere, which is generally used to protect the auxiliary loads like pumps, AC system. This is a compact design integration that can also be dismounted from the top and using also two small power elements here. Connectors are also important design blocks. Indeed, it allows safe connection of the PDU and integrating an IHV rail also shielding. One big advantage is to get plug and play solution. You can find there three different examples of connector integration. On the left side, such connector integrated with right-angle power element in green, and then a screw to maintain the compression. The HVRL is connected to the PCB with a small wire harness that you don't see on the picture. At the middle, this type of connector can be connected with a power element bush and bus bar, like a bus bar style mounting. The HVRL is also connected with a separate cable. Then for this connector on the right side, here it's a complete different way to integrate the 5-pin connectors. We have created small right-angle PCB that allow us to make the contact with a connection with the contact of the connectors. And then these small right-angle PCB are press-fitted directly to the main board here with small right-angle power elements that you can see there. PDU products are also important in the safety concept of an electric vehicle. Measuring the current and the voltage can often be requested in the system to manage the battery load and the power. You can find on the picture two different types of sensors. On the left side, the current is measured through the small bus bar here, mounted on power elements that are press-fitted to the PCB. The voltage is measured with small cables and connectors on the PCB. On the right side, a Hall effect sensor is measuring the current passing through this green power element here. Isolation monitoring measure and control the isolation resistance between HV potential and the reference ground chassis. The goal is to detect any defect and avoid risk of electrical shocks. It can sometimes be requested to integrate such components in PDU applications. The small PCB module can be mounted on our main board and connected with cables. Now, coming to PDU application and assemblies, let's start with the requirements for such products. First of all, the mechanical requirements. Of course, there are often limited space to fit the PDU in the vehicle. The PDU must be compact. This kind of product is also usually heavy and the weight must be limited. The routing of the cable is also a challenge and the PDU must be adapted to the vehicle needs. Then, electrical requirements. The PDU must withstand high voltage and high current. The insulation coordination is so an important part of the design, also the thermal management. The PDU must also be fitted with safety mechanisms like high voltage interrupt line or equipotential bonding. Regarding environmental requirements, the max temperature is usually limited to 60 or 85 degrees. The vibration level could be from medium to high. A high IP protection is also required, and of course, the product must be qualified regarding these conditions. Finally, regarding components, PDU must integrate quite big components like big fuses, contactors, or specific connectors. Some measurement equipment have also often to be integrated, like voltage or current sensors. To answer these requirements, we are designing our products following these norms. ECE R100 regarding electrical safety of the product. LV123 as a guideline on the component level of an electrical vehicle. DIN EN 60664 regarding the insulation coordination for the clearances, creepage, overvoltage categories, etc. And then the ISO 16750 to define a qualification plan regarding environmental tests, but also LV123 to verify the electrical safety during and after these tests. Let's come to some design examples. We are proposing many designs based on needs of our customers. We have also designed a demonstrator product named HVPDU 600. Here you can see some HVPDU 600 application. This product uses some design blocks already saw in the precedent chapter. As you can notice, this is a compact design integrated into a sealed die-cast aluminum box. But let's go more in detail of the different functions. This PDU has been designed for a voltage of 600 volt DC max and continuous current of 200 ampere. In the block A, you can see the input fuse of 400 ampere with a current measurement system integrated. A pre-charge circuit with PTC and small contactor protects the biggest contactor F, which is directly connected to the PCB. Then, some small fuses are present to distribute and protect the current to the auxiliary. This product integrates a HVIL for HV connectors, and a switch to detect the opening of the lid is also integrated. This is a full plug-and-play solution, as all input and output are connectorized for HV and LV. All HV cables have been removed for such design. One advantage of this is that the insulation distances are frozen in the PCB layout of the board, and the risks are minimized. We are thinking about designing standard product also, and we will be happy to get your input regarding your needs and requirements. Here another application, a classical before and after picture. This is a customer-specific design we have done for one of our customers. At the top, you can see the PDU realized with hard wires and bus bars. At the bottom, our solution to improve the assembly. The customer integrates this PCB in a known enclosure, and we deliver only the board. The first point to notice is, of course, the compactness. A lot of interconnection wires and bus bars between the components are replaced by copper tracks on the PCB. This solution will reduce a lot the assembly timing, but more important, it will reduce drastically the risk of cabling errors, bad assembly, or reduction of insulation distances during the life length of the vehicle. You can find here two other examples of custom PDU. This integrates different connector types, different contactor types, different fuse. We can design different range of PDU adapted to the needs of your system with different sizes of box to integrate the components. After this real application example, let me speak about how with PDU based on PCB technology, we can answer the market expectations. First of all, the market is searching reliable and quality, high quality and safe solutions. Our solutions are compact and robust design based on press fit. We remove as much as possible cabling inside our boxes to reduce the risk. We have also multiple testing during our production process to ensure the quality of our product. The market is also looking for solutions suitable for mass production. We are using established technology with press fit elements and PCB solutions. We have a lot of press fit contacts on the field and our production process is already in place. We also reduce the different assembly steps to gain in productivity. As seen at the start of the presentation, there are many types of vehicle and architecture. This e-mobility market is also a moving one. That's why high flexibility is requested. We are working with different type and size of enclosure in order to fit the needs of the vehicle. Everything inside these boxes can be customized by using design blocks. And of course, the market requests some price efficient solutions. By using PCB solution, we can remove a lot of internal wires and bot bar that are usually cost driver components in the product. This will lead to smaller design and smaller products. Then by using design blocks, we can also work with preferred components to increase the quantities. And plug and play solution will also reduce a lot the assembly time of the vehicle. After PDU application, let me speak about another product range that is also based on PCB solution and using our design blocks. This is the filter box product. We saw in the past year more and more requests from our customers to get an EMC filter between the AC charging plug and the onboard charger. This is of course depending on the vehicle and its components, and unfortunately the need of such product appear at the end of the vehicle development. If there are some deviation in the EMC testing. The result is that the vehicle can be certified and a quick solution must be found. Here you can see an EMC filter for a small vehicle which is placed between the charging plug, domestic grid, and the onboard charger. This solution was designed and industrialized in a very fast timing in order to ensure the first production of the vehicle. It was developed within the Wirth Electronic Group by using competencies and components from our company ISOS. This example of filter box is a little bit different. It's placed between a three-phase charging plug and the two onboard chargers of the vehicle. In this case, filter box is also realizing the junction of the onboard charger with the plug. You can notice that this product is using one of the design blocks you saw before. Indeed, the three HV connectors are connected to the bottom main board with small right-angle PCB. We have also designed a specific die-cast enclosure in this case. If you have a filter to integrate in a box, please don't hesitate to contact us. So now I come to the end of my presentation. Today we looked at the different vehicles architectures which lead to various types of PDU requirements. We saw that press fit technology allows easy and safe connection to PCB. PDU based on PCB technology are compact plug and play solutions. The main message I wanted to give you today is that there is no such thing as a perfect one fits of all power distribution solution. It can be designed in different ways depending on your needs, vehicle requirements. Therefore, we are always available to develop the ideal power distribution solution for you. We will be pleased to discuss possible projects with you. Thank you very much for your attention and the numerous participation in today's webinar. I hope we were able to take some of the information with you, and I look forward to your feedback. Let's now have a look to the questions.
Yes, thanks a lot, Ludovic, for your interesting presentation. As you already mentioned, we would like now to turn our attention to your questions. So feel free to enter your questions in the question window so that Ludovic can answer them. We will wait a little second, but maybe we can start with the first one. Ludovic, are you able to provide PDU for fuel cell architecture?
Yes, good question. Of course, the architecture of a fuel cell vehicle is really similar to the architecture of fuel battery electrical vehicle. In this case, for us, the PDU is also a component that is present of this vehicle, and we can also create specific PDU for that to connect the stack to the battery and to the different aggregates of the vehicle.
Perfect, thanks. And which kind of enclosure are you using?
We are using, oh, sorry, good. Okay, so we are using die-cast aluminum housing standard from the market that we are reworking. We can also create specific stainless steel housing based on metal sheet. Or in depending about the vehicle requirement or the quantity, we can also create specific die-cast enclosure with toolings, injection tooling. So we have really the possibility to use different technology for the housing. That will depend about the vehicle needs and the project requirements.
Thanks. Perfect. And maybe one last question. What are the maximum voltage and maximum current?
I didn't mention that. That's a good question. Usually the max voltage that we have on our PDU is 950 volt DC. We don't have a project more than 1000 volt DC. Regarding the current, it's really depending about the vehicle conditions, the environmental conditions also, but I would say that's something about 400 ampere maximum, depending about the conditions.
Thanks. I just saw another questions coming in. Maybe we can answer another one. Which type of PCBs did you use for such high current?
So for such high current, we are using FR4 multi-layer PCBs with specific requirements for the press fit. Regarding the copper thickness, we have also some high requirements with 105 or 140 micrometers regarding the copper layer. So this is really some PCBs that are adapted for the high current technology.
Perfect, thanks. And another question, are you using watertight connectors?
Yes, of course. I didn't mention that, but the IP requirements for such products are really high. We are using watertight connectors, IP67, IP69K connectors that are specific for the HV market.
Sounds good. Another question, is the 400 ampere the maximum continuous current?
Yeah, it's really deep, could be, but it's really depending about the environmental condition, the temperature, the usage time. So for continuous current, we can go up to 400 ampere, but it's really have to be discussed in detail. We cannot just give a limit like that. It's really depending about the temperature inside the box, the temperature of the vehicle, and so on.
Perfect. Thanks. I think that were all questions. If there are any questions left, we will answer them via email afterwards. But for now, thank you very much for your attention. I hope you enjoyed our presentation, and I hope you enjoyed the second day of the Digital Days. Tomorrow is our third day, and you can still register for the individual sessions, so feel free to register to the sessions for tomorrow and Thursday. And I would say see you tomorrow and have a nice evening. Goodbye.
Thank you. Goodbye.